Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back playing Jurassic Park. Let's build in Minecraft, that's kind of the right order. And today we're going to work on our Triceratops paddock. I know what people are going to say to me, BestInSlot, they don't go to the Triceratops next. I just imagine that's how you guys sound. No, they do actually go to the T-Rex, and then the Triceratops, and then the T-Rex, because the course ends and it kind of loops back on itself. However, that would require two versions of the T-Rex, or lots of redstone malarkey, and the fact is I don't think the first time you see the T-Rex exhibit is that important in the film. It's got a cool scene with a goat, but it's not like a big pivotal moment. Clarence, what do you want? It's not like a huge pivotal moment, you know? So we are going to go Triceratops into T-Rex, into I believe Dilophosaurus, if I've remembered the order, that's what it should be. Anyways, I've been working a little bit, I've not done too much, and that would be an absolute lie. So I've been experimenting with this as a road start. It's obviously very, very basic, and I've not done that much of it just because I'm not sure I'm sticking with it. But I think if the whole road in the game looked like this, with the track going down the middle, that would look pretty nice. I don't know, I'd love some opinions about this. And people have suggested different things in the middle. The problem is I do need to put a track here. So I can't have, like, for example, the bottom bits we were using on the electric fence, which would look really good for a track, but you can't put a track on it, so we can't go there. This is very basic, very simple, but I think it looks nice, all the different textures and stuff. I would have liked to use some sort of cobblestone and, well, some mossy cobblestone, stuff like that. Unfortunately, it has this weird transparency issue like a lot of the other blocks, and I still haven't managed to fix it. Right. Okay, so, what are we doing today? Well, we are doing the Triceratops exhibit, which is not an exhibit you really get a good look at in the film. So we're gonna have a little bit of creative leeway here, but as we head down here, we're going to go past the Dilo exhibit. You'll see I have TNT in my hands, and there's a very good reason for that. A lot of people have suggested that I make the fence taller, and I don't think the fence is taller in the film. I think this is about the same, about the right size, because this is lower by a block as well. Especially if I get rid of this bit here. I think that's about the right height for the Dilophosaurus. I don't know. Maybe it does need to be one taller. Maybe they could jump that. I just don't see a Dilophosaurus as a particularly jumpy creature, you know? If it was a raptor, I'd say this is highly inappropriate. But it's not a raptor. It's a Dilophosaurus. Maybe I do need to up it by one. We shall see. I shall have a little think about that. But what I'm really interested in is what you guys think about the road. How I should build it to look good. It has to be 5 wide. This is obviously only 3, so this will get pushed out by one, so you will actually be a little bit closer to this as well. Anyways, as we head down here past our hello lovely, how you doing, girl? Good. You're gonna head down here. I haven't done the path for this because, you know, this just took so long, but you're gonna go down here and you're gonna turn right as they come into the Triceratops exhibit. It's actually on their left, but that's just not how the world's worked out, basically, so it's gonna be on the right hand side instead. Is it on their left? It is. They all come out of the moving car and they all jump out of the left side of the car. As we're watching it, they're jumping out of the right, but obviously that would mean it's actually from the left. But they're just driving along on the track, right? And in this kind of direction. If you imagine this is the left and not the right, they're driving along like this and they all hop out of the car and run over here to the Triceratops. So this right here took so long. This was a mountain. I mean, this whole area was a, this is like the river that was connected to the side of the mountain. This took so long, and it isn't even just that this took so long, it's that it ended up obviously with a very flat edge here. So what I was using the TNT for was going around the edges, putting the TNT down, blowing it up to try and make a sort of more natural looking cliff shape. I made a little cave down here. I don't like the corner of that cave, let's fix that. Made a little cave down here. There's a little waterfall that just naturally happened, so I thought, yeah, we'll keep that, and I knocked down the bottom half of that as well to make that a little bit more natural looking. I'm really trying to emphasize how dedicated I am to making this work, because I've spent a whole lot of time doing this in the last couple of days to get ready for this video. And this is going to be our big old Triceratops exhibit. It's probably not going to be the size of the entire thing. This is excessive. Potentially. I do need to think about that. I'm not doing this. Where's my TNT? This is what we needed. Have some TNT there, have some TNT there, have some TNT there, have some TNT there, Just do those and see what happens. Pachow! See? It's so much easier. I can't believe I've not been doing this all game. Using World Edit, you naturally get very man-made looking areas. If I can then do this, it just... I mean, you have to do a little bit of cleanup duty at the end, don't get me wrong. But by and large, it's just a whole lot quicker than any alternative. It's cool. It's cool. I'm very glad. There's going to be a lot of TNT play in the rest of this series now that I've sort of remembered that this is a thing. And that'll do. It's just, yeah, that's fine. Okay, so we need a bone meal back. For some reason, I replaced that with my flint, because I'm dumb. Lovely job, Blake. Right, so we're just going to plant a bunch of trees and see what happens. Say, see what happens. We know what's going to happen. There's going to be a bunch of trees. That's kind of, you know, the point of planting a bunch of trees. You get a bunch of trees. And then we'll grab ourselves our invisible blocks and just sort of make a pen for the Triceratops that it won't be able to escape out from. Because you don't see the edge, we can... I mean, it's a Triceratops, right? I'd imagine it would have a fairly big exhibit. That would be my assumption anyway. It's a big old herbivorous dinosaur. It needs to be able to graze plenty of times. It needs to be able to roam around. Maybe there's more than one Triceratops, we just don't see it in the film. You know, we don't know. Actually, we know, at least in the book, there are at least some baby Triceratopses as well. Unfortunately, I don't think there's a way for me to lock a Triceratops into being a baby. Which would be pretty cool. We are only going to put one in, because the point, obviously, is to recreate the film, not to put in any aspirations we may have had about a baby Triceratops in Jurassic Park. And we only see one Triceratops in the film, so we're only going to have one Triceratops. What a big tree! Big tree! Right, we're just going to try the dirt. Because what we need, ladies and gentlemen, is a massive pile of feces. I want that detail in, you know? It may be crap, but it's in the film, and that's what matters. That looks pretty good, right? That looks... If you saw that next to the Triceratops, I think you'd think, yeah, that's a giant pile of poo. I think I'm sold on that. I think I'm just going to do a couple of these. Because they are pretty big. I don't think there's a way to make them smaller and look good at the same time. Okay, that's slightly becoming a swastika. Let's just keep an eye on that. I think I've done accidental swastikas in my games before, and I don't think I want to do it again. What was it? Oh, was it Jurassic Park Operation Genesis? We did an accidental swastika. Yeah. Oops. There we go. Glorious mounts of feces. Right, and what we also need is our invisible blocks, which is this lovely thing right here, and we want to block off a nice area for the Triceratops. And I'm going to keep it down this sort of middle area. Oh no. Oh no, this is going to be really difficult unless I know the code. If I don't know the code... This is fine. What could possibly go wrong? No, I have to go get the code. This is going to go horribly. SRM-show. SRM. Secret room mod-show. Got to try to remember that one. It's so important, and I just keep forgetting. Okay, let's just do it to that. This is just such a good way of keeping a dinosaur in the area you want, while still giving the illusion of a big, wide, open exhibit. I think we might need to put, so let's imagine you come down, and the road is going to go along here. I want them to have that same thing of where they could jump out the side of the moving vehicle and run over to the Triceratops track, right? So the car is going to come down here, and everyone's going to jump out and run to the right-hand side. And I believe they sort of run through some trees and some heavy bushes. No, it's like heavy bushes. and then it clears out a bit more, right? This is actually too close now. The poo has made me realize that I've got more room than I thought I did. So I want it like here, I think. Yeah. So the road will be along here. You look over to the right. That's much better. Run through lots of heavy bushes here. Don't know how I'm going to do that, but I will. And you'll merge into here. Just thinking, what I could do, theoretically, instead of doing this, I mean, I'm going to finish this because I've started, but I kind of want the Triceratops to not move, you know? That'd be good. If the Triceratops doesn't move, it kind of maybe helps create the illusion that it's ill, at least. It's illin, you feel me? So maybe, instead of doing this, what we do is create, like, if not moving, but we just create, like, a little boundary for the Triceratops right here. Don't know how big it's going to be. I'm just going to estimate a size and we'll work from there. I wonder if a Triceratops can get over a one block high thing. I'm going to assume no, but that may be folly. You know what? It's easy enough to... There we go. Okay, we're going to put a Triceratops in here. That might have been perfect. He needs to turn around, though. Look at him! Oh my god, he's awesome! I don't think I've ever seen the Triceratops from this mod before. I think, because this is Fossils and Archaeology, I think we've always seen the Jurassic Craft one. Or is this Jurassic Craft? Or the other... Wait, what? This heard a block get destroyed. Am I crazy? I've turned block breaking off! What are you doing? Okay, I'm not convinced that it is a Jurassic Craft. I think it is a Fossils and Archaeology one, because I checked my block breaking, and the thing that I had turned off in the past was turned on for some reason. So, I'm hoping this will work now, but we'll find out. I knew you were going to do that. But, in theory, you shouldn't escape, should you, my beautiful, beautiful... Look at how pretty you are. I'm so proud of you. Does your mama know you're so pretty? She probably does. Look at him. Triceratops and a giant pile of feces. What more could you possibly want? I wish I could find a way to half kill it. That sounds really mean, but... I need it lying down. I don't see a way to do it. But through the grass and then... Oh my god, it's a Triceratops! How you doing, beautiful? You're so pretty. Okay, I think I'm pretty happy with this. I don't really know what else to change. This is... I might spread the feces out. The feces feels a little bit too close to the Triceratops now, so I might move that pile a bit to the left, that pile a bit back and to the right. At the moment, it's too centered. It's too centered in the middle of the exhibit kind of thing. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with it. I think it looks pretty good. Alternatively, if I add more feces towards that back left, it'll make it look a little better as well, I think. Look at it. Guys, look at it. Are you looking? You should be looking. You're so pretty! I don't really know what else to do, like, with this exhibit. I honestly don't think there's anything else that needs to be done, really, other than maybe moving the feces. This is what the exhibit looks like. It's a very basic exhibit, which is good, because the next two episodes are very detailed. We have to do the tunnel, and a lot of stuff with that. The good thing about the tunnel is that in the film, you don't actually see how it's made. You know, you don't see inside the tunnel at any point, really, except, like, at the very, 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 very end, potentially. So, what that means is that we can actually do anything we want with the tunnel. In terms of where it takes you. I think it'd be quite nice to have, like, a little underground section, you know? So you'll go down the road, but go down here, go along here, hop out and see the Triceratops, and then curl back. And I think you're going to go inside this mountain. I think that's what we're going to do. And you're going to go through like a little tunnel adventure, probably turn See, I kind of want to go this way instead. Oh, do I? I don't know. See, this jungle isn't the type of jungle I like. I'd like to stick more to this sort of nice bright green. I'm trying to think. Maybe we go over there. So you go in there, and the tunnel leads you all the way along here. And you come out somewhere over here. What you could do is come out here. I could flatten that. Get rid of all this water as well. Tunnel drags you around here. You come up, you come out of the tunnel here. This is flat. You're going to curve around to the right. And the T-Rex would be here. And we'll flatten this. And this would be the cliff edge. That might work. That might work. I don't mind the tunnel being big. We can put some stuff in there to make it more interesting as well, you know? This is a little better when... When I've got sort of the idea of what I'm definitely doing, I can make this whole area look a little bit nicer. But that's pretty much it, guys. We're pretty much done. Thank you for all the support. Let me know what we should do with the road and the T-Rex. I like that idea for the T-Rex, though. And I think that's probably what I'm going to roll with. I think that makes the most sense. That's the best way to get to the next location that actually has, you know, any potential to actually look like the T-Rex exhibit, and I really want it to be in that jungle. Plus, it'd be good to get away. We've kind of just curled back on ourselves. We haven't actually got anywhere. I mean, the entrance is right there. You start there, and you've gone like that. So it'd be good to go, whew. You know, we can always curl around this way to the left and stuff like that and end up back here at some point with the visitor center, blah, 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 but... From the sky, you can really see that I've worlded that, can't you? You can't really tell from the ground. I mean, you can tell a little bit, but it's not as bad. But from up here, you can definitely tell it's just like a big-ass chunk out of the world. And the trees don't help, oddly enough. Okay. A little Triceratops. I suppose you can see it from up here. I'm going to land on it. Are you ready? This is actually a really cool way to view everything we've done. I'm going to move forward a little bit, see if we can bring in the other bits. This is really cool. Why is this really cool to me? I don't really know. Okay. Yeah, we're going to end it there. Thank you very much for joining me. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye.